Hello, welcome back. Now let us see how to insert an image on the HTML page. It is very simple. You have to use the image tag img, and here we will use the attribute of this tag, that is src. src is the abbreviation for source, and here we will give the path of the source. If the source is available on the internet, you will have to give the whole URL of the internet. Otherwise, if it is located in your local directory, you can give the local path. For now, I have the image in the same directory as my page, so I can simply use this name. So I write the name of the image, canada.jpg, and here we close the tag. Since it is a single tag, it doesn't have the closing tag, so it is usually a convention that we use this forward slash. Of course, if you do not use this forward slash, HTML will not give any error, but it is a convention that we use this forward slash. So now the image has been added on your page. We save the page here and go back to the folder, open this browser, and here you can see that image. So the size of the image is huge. We can resize the image. The perfect way, the correct way to resize the image is through style sheet, but for now you can find a workaround. You can use the attribute of this image tag. The attributes are width and height. So I set the width. Width is set in pixels, so I say, suppose it must be 400 pixel wide, and its height should be also 400 pixel. So the new height and width will be set. So I save the page and reload the page. So here the image has been adjusted, resized according to the given dimensions. So the next is how to insert a hyperlink on your page. Actually, the website is not a compact software like desktop application. In website, every page is an independent page. First of all, we create standalone pages, and then we connect those pages through hyperlinks. So hyperlink is very important in websites. So let us see how to insert a hyperlink on your web page. It is also very easy for hyperlink. The tag is anchor tag. Anchor is like which is used in the ships to anchor the ships with the for loading and unloading the let's use the anchor tag. It is A for anchor. So next we use href. Here we will give the path of that page where we want to go from the current page. So if the page is on the internet, you will have to give the whole path from the internet. Otherwise, you can use the local path if the page is located in your own directory. So if we want to go to Google, you will write here the internet path for google.com, http like this .google.com. Here we close the this is the opening tag, and then we use the closing tag for this, and that is followed by the forward slash. So whatever we write between these two tags, it will appear on the page. So I write here click to go to google.com. so this statement will be appeared on the web page, and by clicking this link, you will land on this page. Similarly, you can also use the link for local page. For local page, you do not need to use this HTTP. You just have to give the path of the local page, like a href. Like I have a local page in my directory, that is, this is a local page. I copy its name, ufun.html. So I write it here, ufun.html, and here write something that will appear on the page. Click for ufun, and here I close this tag. So that's it. I save the file and go to the page and reload it, and that's it. Here we get two links. This is the first link. This is the second link. Clicking on this link, we will go to google.com. Right now I don't have internet, so it will not be shown, no internet connection. But here, as we do have this page on our local drive, so we will land on that page by clicking here. So this is the page that we have on the local drive. So this is it. Actually, these two links are rendered in the same line. You can there are many other useful tags in HTML. To go to the next line, you can use the br tag. Br is for line breaking. So I use the br tag between these two tags. So here a line break will be inserted between these two links. I save the page and here reload it. So this is the first link and this is the second link. Similarly, in HTML, if you want to comment something, this is the way how to comment the something. Whatever will come in between, it will be commented out. So this is the opening of the comment and this is the ending of the comment, and so these tags will be commented out. I saved the page and here I reloaded it. So it has been commented. And in addition to that, there are many other useful tags. Like in Microsoft Word, you have the option of leads, number list and unnumber list. Similarly, ordered list and unordered list. Similarly, in HTML, you can use those tags. For order list, you have the tag of OL. Open the tag and close the tag. And suppose we want to put the list of countries. And here we make a list item, open and close. Suppose here we say Canada and copy. I copied the item, list item USA. Pakistan. So automatically it will be appeared as a list, and these tags are like this list tag and this h1 tags. These are not only important for the formatting, these are also very important from the perspective of Google indexing. Like when Google sees something between this heading tag, Google understands that this is very important text, because the whole page will deal with this topic. So it indexes the page accordingly. So like if the heading of the page is humans, so Google will understand that the whole content of the page will be about humans. Similarly, if this is the list, so it will also be in, very helpful in indexing for Google. So I save the page and reload the page. So here the list of countries, the list was automatically numbered 1, 2, 3. So we didn't use the numbering explicitly, it was automatically added to the list. Similarly, we also have a tag of unordered list. I copy and paste the whole text, and suppose I add a line break here and paste this text here. So this time I, instead of using order list, I use unorder list. That's UL, and I save the page by Control S and go to the web page and reload the web page. And here we get another list. This is the unordered list. So for now, you know, this we do not have applied any style, so it is very crude and rough version. And to make these elements and this text stylish, we need to apply cascaded style sheet CSS. That will be followed after next couple of lectures. So for now, that's it. In the next lecture, we will see how to insert a table in HTML web page. Thanks.